Greetings. If you are Muslim, I encourage you to watch this whole video to gain knowledge. In part 2, I focused on the many prophets calling God their Redeemer. But it did not really do justice to the depth of this topic at the core of the message of the prophets. So thanks to a brother in Christ, nicerperson, who has found these other verses from the message of the prophets. Genesis 48:15. He blessed Joseph and said, "The God before whom my fathers Abraham and Isaac walked, the God who has been my shepherd all my life to this day. The angel which redeemed me from all evil, bless the lads, and let my name be named on them, and the name of my fathers Abraham and Isaac, and let them grow into a multitude in the midst of the earth." Exodus 6:6. Wherefore say unto the children of Israel, "I am the Lord, and I will bring you out from under the burdens of the Egyptians, and I will rid you out of their bondage, and I will redeem you with a stretched out arm and with great judgments." Exodus 15:13. In your loving kindness you have led the people whom you have redeemed. In your strength you have guided them to your holy habitation. Delivering Israel out of Egypt was an act of redemption. Leviticus 25:54, talking of the slaves who will be freed in the year of Jubilee. "And if he be not redeemed in these years, then he shall go out in the year of Jubilee, both he and his children with him." Slaves were redeemed or freed from debt in the year of Jubilee. Deuteronomy 15:15. "And thou shalt remember that thou was a bondman in the land of Egypt, and the Lord thy God redeemed thee. Therefore I command thee this thing today." Over and over, God rescued or redeemed his covenant people, Israel. 2 Samuel 4:9. "And David answered Rechab and Baanah, his brother, and the sons of Rimmon the Beerothite, and said unto them, As the Lord lives, who has redeemed my soul out of all adversity." 2 Samuel 7:23. "And what one nation in the earth is like thy people, even like Israel, whom God went to redeem for a people to himself." Nehemiah 1:10. "Now these are thy servants and thy people, whom thou hast redeemed by thy great power and by thy strong hand." Job 19:25. "As for me, I know that my Redeemer lives, and at the last he will take his stand on the earth." Psalm 103:3. "Who pardons all your iniquities? Who heals all your diseases?" Psalm 138. "And he will redeem Israel from all its sins." See, Psalms 103:3 says, "Who pardons all their iniquities." Pardoning of iniquities, forgiving of sins, is redeeming. It's done by redemption from the sins. This is what Prophet David said in the Psalms. "And he will redeem Israel from all its sins." Proverbs 23:11. "For their Redeemer is mighty. He shall plead their cause with thee." Prophet Solomon called God their Redeemer. Jeremiah 15:21. "And I will deliver thee out of the hand of the wicked, and I will redeem thee out of the hand of the terrible." Jeremiah 31:11. "For the Lord has redeemed Jacob and ransomed him," paid a ransom, "from the hand of him that was stronger than Jacob." Jeremiah 50:34. "Their Redeemer is strong. The Lord Yahweh of hosts is his name. He shall thoroughly plead their cause, that he may give rest to the land and disquiet the inhabitants of Babylon." Over and over, the prophets say God is the Redeemer of his covenant people. Lamentations 3:58. "O Lord, thou hast pleaded the cause of my soul. Thou hast redeemed my life." Hosea 7:13. "Woe unto them, for they have fled from me, destruction unto them, because they have transgressed against me. Though I have redeemed them, yet they have spoken lies against me. God loves us first, even knowing we will not receive it graciously and thankfully. Hosea 13:14, I will ransom them from the power of the grave. I will redeem them from death. O death, I will be thy plagues. O grave, I will be thy destruction. Repentance shall be hid from mine eyes. The beauty of the message of the prophets is how perfectly the new covenant fits with the old covenant. 1 Corinthians 15:54. Then, when our dying bodies have been transformed into bodies that will never die, this scripture will be fulfilled. Death is swallowed up in victory. O death, where is your victory? O death, where is your sting? I will ransom you from the power of the grave. I will redeem them from death. Not just from the Egyptians, from death. O death, I will be thy plagues. O grave, I will be thy destruction. Micah 6:4, for I brought thee up out of the land of Egypt, and redeemed thee out of the house of servants, and I sent before thee Moses, Aaron, and Miriam. Zechariah 10:8, I will hiss for them, and gather them, for I have redeemed them, and they shall increase as they have increased. So many times in the Old Testament, the prophets repeat that God redeems. God is the Redeemer. Clearly, this is integral to the message of the true prophets of God. And some questions beg to be asked. No demand to be answered. Could any prophet truly from God not know God is the Redeemer? I do not think it is possible. Could any religion from God not know God is the Redeemer? I do not think it is possible. And yet Islam, which has 99 names for the spirit it calls Allah, does not have one single name that means Redeemer. The Quran does not have one single ayat that says Allah loves first. But the message of the prophets is full of this revelation of Yahweh, God. And what of the New Testament brought by Yeshua the Messiah? Did the New Testament suddenly stop calling God the Redeemer? On the contrary, while the Old Testament focused on redemption from Egypt and the promise of redemption from sin, the New Testament records the fulfillment of this promise. Luke 1:68, speaking of the presenting of baby Jesus to the temple, blessed be the Lord God of Israel, for he has visited and redeemed his people. From the context, this worships God for the redemption from Egypt, but speaks prophetically of the redemption from sin by the newly born Messiah. Luke 24:21, but we trusted that it had been he, meaning Jesus, which should have redeemed Israel. This was after he was dead. The disciples, knowing the scriptures, expected Jesus to redeem Israel. Realize this was before Paul was saved and began preaching. The disciples thought Jesus would redeem Israel. But who is the Redeemer? The Most High God. The Injil and the New Testament is the revelation God finally did redeem mankind. Galatians 3:13, Christ has redeemed us from the curse of the law, being made a curse for us, for it is written, cursed is everyone that hangs on a tree. Galatians 4:5, to redeem them that were under the law, that we might receive the adoption of sons. Wow! Not only are our sins forgiven by being redeemed, but that redemption includes adoption as God's children. Titus 2:14, who gave himself for us, that he might redeem us from all iniquity, and purify unto himself a peculiar people, zealous for good works. 1 Peter 1:18, for as much as you know that you were not redeemed with corruptible things as silver and gold, from your vain conversation received by tradition from your fathers, but by, now remember what it just said, you were not redeemed with corruptible things, but by the precious blood of Christ, as of a lamb without blemish and without spot. To redeem is to buy back by paying a price. The price paid literally to redeem you was blood. Acts 20:28. Keep watch over yourselves and the entire flock of which the Holy Spirit has made you overseers. Be shepherds of the church of God, which he purchased with his own blood. Revelations 5:9. And they sung a new song, saying, you are worthy to take the book and to open the seals thereof, for you were slain and have redeemed us to God by thy, or by your, blood, out of every kindred and tongue and people and nation. The New Testament agrees with the Old Testament. The message of the prophets reveals God would redeem us from our sins. The New Testament documents the completion of this commitment by Yahweh God. The prophets said God would redeem us. The disciples said God has redeemed us from sin. This is central to the message of the prophets. John 1:29. The next day, John saw Jesus coming toward him and said, look, the Lamb of God who takes away the sin of the world. If you are Muslim, you have been taught Paul created lies which made Christianity. But this is Prophet John, who you say you respect. This was before Paul ever became a believer. This was before Jesus had taught or had been crucified. If you are Muslim, please think what this really means. The next day, John saw Jesus coming toward him and said, look, the Lamb of God who takes away the sin of the world. It means the message of the prophets, including Yahya or John, is that Jesus would die to redeem us from our sins. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth of the message of the prophets, and your heart to his Son, the Lord Jesus Christ, who has redeemed us from our sins. Amen.